I love that verse because when they ask me to sing, that's what I do. I just make a joyful noise. Not just his presence, but singing. I think that helps this church when we come in here because we sing and we sing the old songs and y'all sing along and it just does your heart good to sing out. Verse 3, know ye that the Lord, he is God. Do you know that? Do you know he is God? He is the Almighty God. He can do anything he wants to do.
Amen.
He's in control of everything.
Yeah.
That's the same. And the sheep of his pasture. When you read that verse, you think about what's going on. You think about the shepherd. He's got his sheep out there. And if you go and study, the Bible says he's the good shepherd. A shepherd looks after them sheep. If a storm comes, he protects them. He runs the wolves away. He takes care of them. He uses the rod, the bag, and Denise had every one of them today. And he uses that little crook to guide them. That hook, got them back over here. Get them in line. She knows she had a belt with one of our grandchildren generations. Through today is the day it was wrote.
Amen.
His mercy endures forever. Don't matter what we're going through, his mercy endures forever. He's going to look after us, his children, just like we look after ours. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, into the courts with praise. Be thankful and bless his name. The Bible says it's a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord and to sing praises. That's why I asked them to stay up here and want us to sing all night. Even in the midst of the storm, we've got so much to be thankful for. We've got so much to be thankful for. If we just stop looking at all the trials and the tribulations we're going through and the gloom and look to Jesus. A few years back, bad time, dark time, God brought us through it. Put somebody else in her life. Brother Chris sitting back here lost his wife. He just had a battle with cancer. God brought him through it. That's the God I serve.
Amen.
We got a lot to thank him for. Psalm 69:30. It says, I will praise the name of God with a song. Praise him. We sing songs in here. We try to make sure the songs we sing gives glory to God.
Yeah.
We do that. Some of the bluegrass songs sometimes get just a little on the edge. It's just the meaning's there. It's about the old church and stuff. But it's still about Jesus. But we try to sing songs that are with thanksgiving. When I read that verse, I don't know, it's been a long time since I played with a magnifying glass. I use one now, but I don't play with it. I read with it. But you catch a little old ant and get that big old magnifying glass and you just make that big. And I thought about that verse, George. We sang about him. Let's magnify him. Let's let the world know how big our God is.
Amen.
Let's thank God. Public. I hope somebody will. But thank God. You can sit there in that pew when you go home tonight. Thank where God brought you from and where God's got you now.
Amen.
And then think about where his promise is going to take you.
Yeah.
And you'll start thanking God.
Amen.
You'll thank him. It's good. The Bible says it's a good thing to give thanks to God. Yes. You go home. Here's your good example. You go home tonight, and you go in your house, get rid of everything but a bag of sugar and a bag of flour, and if you look, you keep one pair of shoes and one pair of clothes. He just started talking about all the stuff. Take it all out of your house. He does missionary work there. He went back, came here to study, went back there to do missionary work. He said, those people are lucky to have a bag of sugar, a bag of flour, a bag of rice. And he said, every home I visit here, the cabinets are full. And nobody thanks God for it.
And I tell you right now, I've never been a part of him, but he's never turned his back on me.
Amen.
He's always been good to me, and I just thank him for it. I really do. And just talking about the Bible, and years ago, me and my wife, we'd start somewhere, we'd didn't travel a whole lot. She had, I believe she called it GPS. You could put the address in it, and it'd just take you right where you were going. The Bible is the GPS to help.
That's right.
And I just thank God for what he's done for me. And I do know when I leave this old world where he's taking me.
Amen. It's good to know that. Amen. Anybody else?
Yeah, preacher, I didn't grow up in a Christian home. My parents weren't Christians, and they never went to church, and my brothers never went to church. But my mama made sure I went to Sunday school, and I went to church, and I got spanked if I didn't go. And I wish the family had gone, but I praise God that she made me go. I praise God for that.
You know, we hear the news and hear the reports on the coronavirus and COVID, whatever you want to call it. I'm just thankful we're not none of us have it. I thank God he's kept us all safe so far.
Amen.
Instead of looking at the gloom of it, I remember somebody being in here, and this is going to have to help me. It's the cowboy and his wife when it's talked about what is.
And Tracy.
Yeah. You remember what she said that night?
You don't even remember. If.
I can't remember exactly how she said it.
Beth says it's even if.
Sister Beth.
Yeah, she said even if.
Even if. Yeah. We were talking about stuff and she said, she stood up, she hardly ever said anything in here. She said, all the things you go through, I always hear people say, what if? What if you go to the store and you're going to get it? What if? So he said, even if I do, God still got me.
Yeah.
You know, and that's the way we need to look at this.
Amen.
And I'm thankful for what you said, Brother Don. He don't ever turn his back on us.
No.
We turn our back on him and walk away from him, but he don't never turn his back on his children.
Amen.
He's always there for us. Anybody else? We're going to sing some songs. Anybody else want to thank the Lord for anything?
Say something. I want you to remember my mother. She went to the post office Monday, and they made her put and she got asthma and bronchitis both. She couldn't catch her breath, and she fell out in the over there in the post office. There was not one person to help her. My sister had called my brother-in-law outside to come in there to help her get her up. He picked her up and took her outside, and they took the mask off her, and all she got better, but she went to stay with my sister.
Wow. Was that, where was that at?
Gastonia.
Gastonia.
Both off in Gastonia. I walk up all in there to get to it.
That's sad. I know I wear mine somewhere. I've seen OPD and it's supposed to be me because I won't wear one cutting grass. They smother me. I mean, it makes it hard for me to breathe, but I do wear them sometimes when I go in and they require them, but I just try not to go in places that make you wear them. And that's in here. If you want to wear a mask in here, wear it. That's up to y'all. I'm not going to make nobody wear no mask. If you think you're safer with a mask, wear it. We got them here. We'll give you one. But I hate to hear that. She was just here a couple weeks ago, too.
Yeah, yeah.
She's in her 80s. She's 80 something.
She'll be 87 in October.
Yeah. Mm. Hope she's okay. Anybody else say anything?
$375, and I said, well, we can offer them $200. So she came up, and she said, did they
we both, well, all three of us started crying because we could just feel the Spirit of the Lord, you know. Her sister said, I can't even think how to hang this picture. I feel like in the middle of a revival. But I just want to praise the Lord for that. And we stood there and we glorified the Lord and lifted him up. And we prayed for this church. And Jean said to tell you all that your prayers are working. God just keeps working out things for her and for me too. And thinking this little cancer on my ear is almost gone now. Doctor said it looks good. It's not a problem. My finger went trigger happy on me last week. Had to go get a shot in it. But it's better, praise God. And I just want to give him all glory.
Amen.
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 Anybody else? Let's sing, Charlie.
Psalm 103. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all of his benefits. And man, does he have benefits.
Yes.
Amen. And he says, who forgiveth all of our sins and healeth all of our diseases. I just want to praise God tonight for his goodness. He's a good God, and I praise his holy name. I bless his soul tonight in Jesus' name. I just praise God. What a wonderful Savior we have.
Yes.
We shouldn't praise. We can't praise him enough for just for that one benefit of forgiving us all of our iniquities.
Yes.
I had so many and still do. And God's forgiven every one of them. And I praise his holy name.
Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
Let's magnify. Let's go
be,
in there and
he needs to be magnified. Instead of us sitting here with lots of them, God needs to be magnified, glorified, praise his name.
I thought we do come in here to worship because we get started in the praise.
We have come into his house and gathered in his name to worship him. We have come into his house and gathered. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. I couldn't make it without Jesus. really know what this song is talking about because I have buried two husbands. And I know what it's like when it says, nor a soul without me. Something for me that I couldn't do for myself. He took all my sins away.
Amen.
And the most beautiful part is, for me, is he, they're as far as the east is yes. from the west. I don't even have to worry about those transgressions. He's taken care of all those I had done when I was 13 till then. And now I'm 81 and I have transgressed so many times. But he's taken all of those and they're gone. I praise him. I love him.
Amen.
For the family that he let me be born into, a wonderful mom and dad. And I just praise him for the wonderful family that he has given to me in my adulthood. I thank him for Vern. I just thank him for all of these wonderful things. But 68 years ago, he made me his child. Child of the King.
Yeah.
Once I was clothed in the rags of my sin.
Oh yes,
I'm a child.
watches over me, watches over me where I go. Let me tell you about Jesus and what he done for me. How he saved a poor sinner, now my soul has been saved.
Send them a copy of my marriage license. And I went to Gaffney and got one, and it says on there, Daniel E. Blanton, 24 years and 2 months old. Joyce Lee Lane, 21 years and 11 months old. We were married all 55 and a half years. And I don't think I ever, I know I never told her I'm leaving, and she never told me she was leaving. I'd give anything to have her back, but I'm thankful for the 55 years that I had.
Amen.
I made up a song that kind of tells all about it. And we indeed, when my heart is heavy and my reason lost, I go to the Lord.
I'm going to sing a song here, and you know, a long time ago, you used to hear preachers talk about the trumpet. You know, when you hear that trumpet sound, we're listening for it. And I listen for it more today than I ever have in my life. I'm telling y'all what, Jesus may not come in our lifetime, but I think he's a lot closer than he ever was. Because things going on in this world today, I used to get paddlings for in school. And we've got professional people out there acting like a bunch of nuts. And it's just right is wrong and wrong is right. And I'm going to sing When the Rolls Call Up Yonder, because there's that trumpet. Y'all listen for the trumpet one day. That's going to throw all the sinners off guard when they hear a big old trumpet. But I'm going to know what it is, and I know all of us in here, it's going to be in G. Right. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and I shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair, when the saved of the earth shall gather on the other shore, and the roll is called at yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called at yonder, 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 I'll be there. On this wondrous love and care. And when all of life is over and our work on earth is done, and the rose is called the comforter, I'll be there. When the rose is called the comforter, when the rose is called the comforter, Jesus, it's in D. Now, that's what the book says it is. It's in D. I don't have a clue what D and G and all that is. This is a good old song, you know. And you know, when you tell somebody about Jesus, that may be the only time they'll ever hear it. So we're actually walking Bibles. We need, Jesus wants us to tell people about him. That's all we got to do. We just, I strive every day to tell somebody about Jesus. I have today, too, several times. Ready? Tell me the story of Jesus. Write on my heart every word. Tell me the story, most precious, sweetest that ever was heard.
Picturing leaving this earth and leaving this body and my spirit.
Just do it, tell you, or I'll just jump right up here. I felt so all alone. Christmas.